Many Angular developers, even those with years of experience, have a fundamental misunderstanding of template bindings. I'm going to show you what that misunderstanding is and teach you exactly how binding works under the hood so that whenever you encounter a various set of issues about binding, you'll be able to solve it because you understand what's actually going on. But first, I just want to let you know that Enterprise NG is coming this November. This two-day online conference is focused around Angular and the enterprise. It includes talks on micro frontends, monorepos, quality and maintainability, and performance and scalability in the enterprise. Plus, there's 3 days of pre-conference workshops. There's even a keynote from the Angular team, which you can attend for free, although you will have to register for a ticket. Check it out at ng-conf.org or click the link below. Ticket prices do go up on November 5th, so don't procrastinate buying your ticket. All right, so let's talk about bindings. Here I got a very simple app in StackBlitz, and you can see that I've got an H1 tag and an image tag, and we're kind of used to the two types of bindings. If you've done any Angular at all, you know that we can actually bind in values into our elements. For example, we have the text hello there on this H1, but I've also got a variable that has the string hello there in it, and that's called message. And so if I put that in, then we'll see over on the right-hand side that that second H1 now contains that message that's getting put in there. This is a form of interpolation binding these double curly braces. And then we have property bindings, the square brackets, and we're pretty used to those. You can see here there's an image, but if I want to actually have that image's source come from a piece of data, then I'm going to want to use a property binding. And I've got a variable that contains that URL, and it's called img-url. And we're used to this. These two bindings, the double curly braces and the square brackets, let us put data into our template. So these two types of bindings, not everybody understands that they're somewhat interchangeable. So for example, on our image here, if we take out the property binding and instead put in the double curly brace binding, we're going to get the same result. Notice that that second image there still has the correct URL. Let's remove that first image so it's not in the way. We've still got the correct URL on that second image. Even though we're not doing property bindings, that source attribute is still binding correctly. And the reason is because the double curly brace binding is basically a form of string interpolation. The Angular compiler will look at the HTML, and when it finds these double curly braces, it'll insert whatever the value is set for that property. But most developers don't understand the true underlying difference between the double curly braces and the square brackets. They simply think that the square brackets is what we use for properties or attributes, and the double curly braces is what we use when we want to put text inside the value of an element. But that's not true. Those two types of bindings are fundamentally different from each other. And it's really important to understand why that is and what goes on underneath the hood, because there's a lot of problems that you can encounter based on what you're doing. So let's look at an example of that. I'm going to paste in a little form here. And this form is relatively straightforward. It's got two radio buttons, the one that says show, one that says hide. And the text underneath that H2, you can see here it's got an ng if. And it's only going to show up if the value in the form is set to true. And we want to hook that show hide value up to our radio buttons. And we can also see the values printed out down below on line 19. We see that over in the preview. So let's hook up the value of the show hide variable. And I've got a show hide variable already set up. I've created the form. It's got show hide and it's defaulting its value, but we need to bind that now to our input. So we're going to give them a value attribute, which is what you'd normally do with plain HTML. And this one I want to set to true because we want to set the value of the show hide variable to true when that's selected. And down here, this one we want to set to false. So now I'm setting these two values to true and false, and we can watch the binding down below. Value show hide is true. If I click hide, now it's false, and if I click back on show, it's true. So we know that we're setting it correctly, but notice that the text is still displaying. Even when we click hide, this text that should only be shown if the above value is set to show, it's still showing up. So that ng if clause is evaluating to true. Why is that happening? Well, the reason is because our binding is not a expression binding. We're actually binding in the string values true and false. And any string that's non-empty has a truthy value, so that show hide property on the form is actually getting set to a string value. It's of type string. And that's not what we want. We want it to actually be the Boolean value, true or false. And the way that we make that happen, you may be familiar enough with forms to know this, is to do a property binding here. on the property values true and false. And now that we've got that, notice that it's defaulted to be show because I was initially defaulting it to the actual Boolean value of true. And if I select hide, then the text goes away. Now, you may have dealt enough with forms to know that when you do your value property binding, that you need to set the square brackets around that, and you just sort of have that memorized. But understanding what's actually going on underneath the hood with property bindings is what will allow you to diagnose this issue when you discover a new variation of this. When you're doing something else and somehow your property bindings just aren't working, understanding the difference. And the difference is that when we use the syntax for the property binding, the square bracket syntax, what we're actually doing is Angular is treating the right-hand side of our equal sign as an expression, not as a string. The double curly braces is string interpolation. The square brackets creates an expression, and that expression gets evaluated by Angular, and it gets evaluated essentially as a JavaScript. And if you are familiar enough with Angular, you'll know that there's a fair number of things you can do in the expression syntax in the templates. Such as we could do a little bit of Boolean logic here. If we set true and true, we're still going to end up with true when it gets selected, right? But if we were to set this as true and false, then that's going to be false. And anytime we set it to anything, we're hiding everything. So this is an actual expression. We could do all kinds of logic over here. We can multiply numbers. We can append strings. Let's get rid of this and show one other example of this. Say, for example, you have the URL of the image, but you don't have the extension. I actually have a variable for that. So let's go back to the property binding on the source and get rid of these string interpolations. So we just have image URL, which is going to show our image. But let's do image URL no ext. And that's going to be the image URL without the extension. And notice it's a broken image. But if I instead add on the string .png, which is the correct extension, then the image shows back up. Notice I'm using the single quotes inside of the double quotes because it's a string inside of a string. So we got the expression inside of the attribute, and Angular needs us to use a different type of string delimiter, and then it can evaluate that expression. So these are expressions whenever we use the square bracket and create a property binding. But when we use the double curly braces, what we're actually doing is creating a string. And we can see the end result of that by coming back to our value property binding. And let's set this back to just value without the property binding. And again, we just get two strings that are non-empty, so we get two truthy values. But let's use the double curly braces to turn these into Angular expressions. But notice that we still don't have our functionality fixed. No matter whether we select show or hide, it's still showing the value, and that is because this is string interpolation that's happening in the template. So that value true and the value false is getting turned into a string and then stuck into the attribute, the value attribute. When we put on the property binding syntax, though, which we can't mix the two, Angular doesn't like that, so we have to get rid of them because it's already an expression. We don't need any more string interpolation. When we put on the property binding, then Angular is evaluating these as expressions, and underneath the hood, these are going to be expressions and remain expressions and not get turned into strings, unless, of course, we were to manually turn them into a string by doing something like this. And now our true and our false are still strings, and we get the same behavior we saw before. But when we let them be the actual values, then we get the behavior we want. So understanding the difference between those two things, the double curly braces and how those just do string interpolations and adjust the HTML, think of it as manipulating the actual HTML, but the square brackets, those are expressions that manipulate the DOM itself. And that is the fundamental misunderstanding that most Angular developers have. The square brackets manipulate the DOM, the double curly braces manipulate the HTML. I hope you learned something from this video. If so, like, share, and subscribe.